looking forward to it today as well. Our program consists of two drama sketches. You'll want to listen carefully to the words. There's a lot of profound depth to a lot of the things being said, and you won't want to miss a single thing. We appreciate so much the leadership of Holly and Michelle and heading this up, and all the parents and the ones who are participating. It's been a very special thing to be able to see it come together. In your bulletin is a green slip that we invite you to use. If you're a guest here with us, we would appreciate having you fill that out. The offering slot is in the entry area there, and the green slips can just be dropped in there. If you have a prayer request or something you'd like to communicate to us as well, we invite you to use that slip for that purpose as well. Of course, with the program, there's no classes taking place. The infant nursery is staffed, but not the toddler nurseries. It's some of our toddlers are in the program. And they didn't stay in the fields after the angels came. But it says, when the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see the thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. So we hear the message, but when you hear the message of Jesus Christ, it isn't enough just to hear it. You have to do something. You have to come to him by faith and see him, know him for yourself. And then after hearing, as it says, the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just again told, and they went and told others as well, which is the final step. We have received Jesus. The news was announced to us. We meet him ourselves, and then we tell others as the shepherds did. So now we're going to begin our program, and so you can sit back and let the story be told to you.
She ripped through her closet with various items. to her wardrobe, everything drying. At last, she emerged in colors so gracious. And truth be told, she was looking quite bodacious. True to form, Gladys made her house ready. She waited for royalty, feeling quite pretty. When, what did she hear but a knock at the door? She opened it up and saw a girl very poor.
Who are you?
Her hopes for this evening were beginning to sink. light did shine. An angel appeared who was clearly divine. The angel told Gladys about her real worth and reminded her about the humility of Jesus Christ's birth. They talked of her visitors, and God's Spirit helped her see. What you do for the least of these, you do it for me. Gladys now realized the error of her ways. She knelt on her knees and started to pray. It's always amazing what God can redeem. We must remember Christ's birth is completely supreme.
Yeah. talk about everything.
Well, at least you found the clerk. I finally gave up on housework. This is all so exhausting. I mean, my feet hurt, my head hurts, my back hurts.
And my wallet hurts. Hey, look, are those trailers over there?
I think so. And it looks like they're getting ready to sing.
Glorious.
Our God. Strips of cloth and made him in a manger full of hay. The white was an angel sent by God. Angels, do not be afraid. I have good news. The Son of God has been born. You will find him and still will remember him.
All at once, a huge chorus of angels joined the angel. They were singing God's praises. Glory to God in the highest, peace on to all on earth.
The shepherds were excited and went to Bethlehem to find Jesus. When they found Jesus, they were filled with joy. They told Mary and Joseph about the angels in the sky.
A long way away in the east, three wise men who studied the stars saw a new bright star shining in the sky. They knew that this meant a great ruler had come.
We arrived and decided to go find the baby.
The wise men followed the star to the stable in Bethlehem.
They found Jesus lying in a manger.
The wise men gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you.
transition here as we conclude our program. I just love standing with all these angels. I feel just a little bit more special myself. But while we can enjoy it and laugh, it reminds us again that there is one central focus that it's not just for Christmas, but for all of life. That's God's Son, Jesus, who came to earth to be our Savior. And so our prayer is that we can make that good news of the Savior known to all ages, to our community, and from here to the rest of the world. We hope you know Him as your Savior today. And so we're going to conclude with prayer, and then there'll be some time of chaos. But and on top of that, there will be some tables set up and some food brought out. When everything is ready and I get the signal, we'll have another word of prayer then and enjoy dinner together. Father, I thank you for this time we have been able to share together. Very enjoyable, just to rejoice in your many blessings in our lives, but most of all, that indescribable gift, the incomparable gift of Jesus Christ, your Son given to us. And so may we celebrate that this Christmas. May everything else of the activities find their place and priority in relationship to that central theme. Now, bless our time and the remainder of this day and the time we share here together. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for those who prepared this and parents.